Hello again, everyone. It's Matt from Kenhub, and today we will discuss the most common abbreviations in anatomy. There are so many words used to name and describe anatomy. It's not enough that these words themselves are sometimes foreign, but we also need descriptor on top of descriptor to specify exactly what is being talked about. In order to simplify this in writing, there are some standard abbreviations that anatomists use. This video will review them and hopefully make your note-taking easier. We will start by discussing the abbreviations for anatomical structures and then go over the ones for features. There are two things you should know up front. These are abbreviations for the Latin terms, and the plural form is just a repeated consonant. For example, the abbreviation for muscle is M, and for muscles is MM. So, we have begun. For artery, the abbreviation is A, and for arteries, it is AA. V is short for vein, and VV for veins. For cartilage, it's CARTIL. It may not seem like much of an abbreviation, but trust me, every little bit helps when you are writing for memory. GL is short for gland, and for glands, GLL. Same goes for ligament. LIG is singular, and LIGG is plural. The abbreviation for nerve is N, and for an aggregation of nerve cells or nucleus, it's NUCL. For plexus, which is a weave of nerves and vessels together, the abbreviation is PL. For bronchus, the abbreviation is BR. When discussing whether a structure is right or left, in anatomy, we use the terms dexter for right or sinister for left. The abbreviations are DEX and SIN, respectively. POST is the abbreviation for posterior, used for structures found towards your back. And as you can probably guess, the abbreviation for anterior is ANT, for structures you can then find towards the front of your body. Here's a list of other commonly used abbreviations regarding anatomical features. ANG for angle, APERT for opening or aperture, B stands for bursa, which is a fluid-filled sac lined by synovial membrane. DECUS is the abbreviation for crossing or decussation, and MEMBR is short for membrane. And FASC is the abbreviation for fascicle. A fascicle is a bundle of muscle fibers surrounded by a paramecium. PROC is short for process. If you remember, a process is a projection from a structure. And REC for recess, which is a depression or cleft. The Latin term for branch and branches is ramus and rami, so the abbreviations are R and RR. Those terms and abbreviations are commonly used when we're referring to all the branches coming out of the main arteries. Yes, arteries do resemble trees, with a main trunk and all the branches coming out of it. Finally, for suture, the abbreviation is SUT. Don't mix up the term suture, used in anatomy, with surgical sutures. A suture in anatomy refers to a relatively rigid joint found usually between bones. This video is more fun than reading a textbook, right? If you want more videos, interactive quizzes, articles, and an atlas of human anatomy, click on the Take Me to Kenhub button. It is time to say goodbye to your old textbooks and say hello to your new anatomy learning partner, Kenhub. See you there!